I'm Gabrielle Tse. I'm the winner of the 2017 Hong Kong Non-Writers Award.
Describe how you felt when it was announced that you were the winner.
I think I was really touched that someone actually liked my writing, that I put a lot of time into crafting, and I was really hoping that my parents would be proud of me because they were in the audience during the ceremony.
What do you think are the benefits of entering a writing competition?
I think first of all, it really helps, really gives us the drive to give closure to our writing, because as someone who writes a lot, I find that usually when I write for myself, there are two possible endings that can happen, and the first of which is that I write a first draft, I never finish it. I just, okay, stop here, and I think to myself, I'll finish it maybe sometime later, I'll put it aside, and then just forget about it for a few centuries. The second possible option is that it's just a complete opposite. I keep on doing it and doing it and doing it, and I keep on polishing it, but I never find the incentive to finish it. So to me, it's always this unfinished work and a state of limbo. So in both scenarios, it's a really bad. They're both really bad scenarios because, on one hand, you either don't get anything done. Well, in both cases, you don't get anything done. Just really awful. But in the competition, you have this deadline. You have this big, red, horrifying deadline, which kind of pressures you to finish your work, to find closure for it, and find the correct moment to let it go, and come and kind of say that it is finally finished and it is the finished product. And the second thing that, especially with themed competitions, it kind of gives you the prompt to write about things you usually never think of writing about. When you write for yourself, you kind of write about things you know, things that interest you, things that are in your heart all the time. But when you're given a prompt to write about, you're kind of forced to include this new angle in your kind of garden of ideas. And this helps you, your writer's mind, to grow, to incorporate more themes into your repertoire. And this really improves, widens your landscape as a writer.
How did you prepare for the competition this year?
It's really hard to answer about preparation because it's something that's really done, ingrained in your life. You think about stuff and then you hopefully this stuff will come in useful in your writing later, maybe yes, maybe no. But it's not something you kind of consciously work towards, it's something that happens on the way. But as for anything particularly concrete, because you're writing with a particular time and era set in mind, old Shanghai, for this topic, and I really did some research as to the actual place, the actual geography of it, the actual years where some particular events took place, so as to make sure that the facts I'm writing, well not the facts, the story that I'm writing, could have factually taken place in a realistic sense. So this gives more believability to the story I wrote, I think.
Since winning the Hong Kong Young Writers Awards this 2017, has this encouraged you to write anything new that you can share with us?
I think winning competitions really gives you more of a, well, it really gives entrants more of a kind of confidence in writing, because usually you only write for yourself and for your own private eyes only if you write a lot, whether in diaries or blogs, just poetry or something like that. But when you win awards, you kind of get this recognition that you're on the right track, you're doing something that is correct and can in fact be improved in the future. So this gives you the motivation to kind of keep on moving forwards and doing better. And I think after I wrote this thing last year or so, I guess, I kept on writing and I wrote some more poetry and I finished a short story a few days ago. And I'd love to share, if possible, one day.
Do you have any creative tips for students looking to enter this year's competition?
I was told to prepare on lines of research and also on writing skills. So I think with regard to research, I think it's a kind of erroneous idea that you have to set this one allotted hour and that would be your research hour and it's all really fixed and technical. I think that can't be right. I don't think that research should be something that is separate from your daily life. I think it should be really ingrained in your daily life. Like it's something that happens every moment, because in every moment there's something poignant that can, that may strike your mind, strike your heart, that could be possibly incorporated in the things that you do in the future. Any form of art, it could be dance, writing, music, anything. So basically every living moment in life is a kind of research, you know. Anything you notice can be part of your research. So, to raise an example, I was walking with my friends one day and my umbrella was broken by the wind. So I was just cradling my umbrella in my arms, holding it like this, and we noticed that it looked like a kind of a hurt bird, a bird with a broken wing. And so in the end, I incorporated this idea of an umbrella resembling a bird's broken wing into a story as a recurring motif. And so I think this is an example of how research, so-called research, should not be something mechanical or separate. It should be something in your daily life. And with regards to writing skills, I'm not sure if this exactly counts as writing skills, but when I write about a time in a time frame of people, I try to immerse myself into that scenario. For example, I did Shanghai last year, so I try to kind of immerse myself in this Shanghai atmosphere. There's one, like I listen to some old Shanghai music, what I construe to be old Shanghai music. I try to make my own mood board. I try to put some relevant photos and themes together and try to really feel how the scenario would be. Like, I didn't necessarily use these devices to think of how the plot would move forwards, but rather I used these devices to kind of think up how the mood would be presented in the story to make it more believing, more convincing. I didn't want it to be something that could happen right now or anything, because that would lose the theme, the concept of old Shanghai. Wanted it to have that zeitgeist of Shanghai, so I tried to incorporate that using these kind of immersive devices.
Thank you.